In this illustration, we'll analyze the detection of interference by a detector. We are given that two sound sources, each of amplitude A, are having frequency 100 Hz and 120 Hz. And it is given that at a point equidistant from both the sources, a sound detector is placed, which can detect sound only if its amplitude is more than root 3 A. We are required to find the duration for which detector does not detect any sound. Now, in solution, we can draw the situation that there are two sources S1 and S2 with frequencies 100 Hz and 120 Hz respectively, and a detector is placed at equidistant from these two sources. So we can see there is no physical path difference between the sources, but due to difference in frequencies, beats will be observed at the detector. So here we can write at location of detector, beat frequency is, this beat frequency we can write N2 minus N1, that is equals to 20 Hz, as these are 120 and 100 Hz. So if this is the beat frequency, then the angular frequency of amplitude variation at detector is, this omega we can write 2 pi and this is 40 pi radian per second. And we can write further as amplitude of waves from S1 and S2 at detector is A. After superposition, here we cannot call it interference because the waves are not coherent, but for detector, the two oscillations will superpose. So here we can write after superposition, resulting amplitude at detector is given as, this we can write R, which is equals to 2A cos of omega T by 2, as the phase difference between the two waves at detector can be taken as omega T. So the two waves at detector can be taken as, one is having amplitude A and other is also having amplitude A, and the phase difference between them will be omega T, as there is no physical path difference. So no phase difference is introduced due to the path covered by the waves to detector. So the resulting amplitude for the two can be given as 2a cos omega t by 2. And if we draw it and represent it on a circle, then here we can see on this circle, one, the resulting amplitude is oscillating. Then we can see the maximum amplitude is 2a and its value is cos of omega t by 2. So here the particle is considered to be oscillating with an angular frequency omega by 2, and the resulting amplitude will oscillate on the diameter y prime. Now we are given that the detector detects sound only if amplitude is more than root 3 by a. That means whenever the amplitude goes beyond root 3 a, then beyond this point detector will detect. So here we can say detector detects the sound, but before this point, which can be considered to the other point on the other side where this is also root 3 a. So when detector would be detecting the resulting amplitude, when it is from one side root 3a to other side root 3a, or when we can say the resulting particle is moving on circular motion from point x to y, this is a location where we can say d remain idle. Similarly, when it moves up and when it reaches on the other side and from this side to this point, again the detector remain idle. So we are required to find the detector does not detect any sound, the time duration set is from motion x to y. So if this angle is theta, we can write from circular motion a representation of simple harmonic motion at detector, we can write the value of theta is equals to sine inverse of root 3 a by 2a. That is equals to sine inverse of root 3 by 2, which is pi by 3. So we can write time for which detector does not detect any sound can be given as 2 theta upon omega by 2, as the angular frequency here is omega by 2 for the oscillation at detector. So we can write it twice of pi by 3 divided by omega by 2. So in this situation, omega we are having 40 pi. So this can be written as 20 pi. On simplifying this, we are getting 1 by 30 second. That is the result of this problem. When the oscillating particle on circle moves from x to y, it will take 1 by 30 second for which detector remain idle. And again it will sound, and when again it will move from this point to this point, for 1 by 30 second detector will remain idle. And total in one cycle, if we wish to calculate the time for which the detector remain idle, will be twice of this, but we are only required to find the duration for which it does not detect any sound as this, which is the result of this problem.